From the mathematics of Einstein's general relativity comes an object so peculiar, a white hole. The white hole's twin, a black hole, was first thought of in the 18th century by the geologist John Mitchell. In those days, black holes were not considered to be real. Einstein even assumed they didn't exist. Yet Einstein's theory of general relativity predicts and allows a concept named a white hole. More specifically, it's the mathematics of general relativity that say that white holes are possible. If you take the mathematics of a black hole and literally reverse it, you get a white hole. Or even, a white hole is a time-reversed black hole. So, a black hole will not allow any matter to escape once the matter is past the event horizon, an imaginary boundary around a black hole where no matter can escape after passing it. And so, take the opposite of this. So a white hole has an event horizon, as a black hole does, but no matter can enter it. So instead of pulling all material inwards once it's past the event horizon, like a black hole does, a white hole ejects matter and matter can never enter it. Now, you may have noticed that I've been saying that black holes only suck in material when said material is past the event horizon. It's very important to make this distinction. Black holes don't actually suck or pull on things. They're just like any other mass when it comes to gravity. The only difference is that black holes have an event horizon. If you magically replaced the sun with a black hole with the exact same mass as the sun, everything orbiting the solar system would just orbit as they did when the sun was there. The only difference is that sunlight is no longer being emitted because the sun is no longer there, and so all life on Earth would die. But you see the point, it's only when material goes just close enough to the black hole that the speed needed to escape is faster than the speed of light, and it's not possible to go faster than the speed of light. It's often said that once you're in a black hole, you are there forever, and while this is true in the sense that you're never going to escape and you'll die due to spaghettification, it's not true that a black hole lives forever, because they don't. Like everything else in the universe, they eventually fade away, or more specifically, evaporate. This is due to Hawking radiation. All around us, virtual particles are constantly popping into existence. It's often said that they come in pairs, a particle and an antiparticle. After existing for an extremely short amount of time, the two particles recombine and annihilate each other. Now, if you have one of these particle pairs pop into existence at the event horizon, one particle will fall into the black hole, but the other particle is able to escape into space and become an actual particle. And when particles escape, the black hole loses a small amount of its energy and therefore some of its mass, because mass and energy are related by Einstein's equation E equals mc squared. As I said, this is called Hawking radiation. So, by these virtual particles popping into existence at the event horizon, the black hole will eventually evaporate into nothing, but after an extremely long time. So it turns out all we need to do to defeat a black hole is to wait it out. And as we discussed in the last video, there aren't any ways to kill a black hole apart from waiting eons for Hawking radiation to do its thing. I really need to put an emphasis on the fact that white holes are entirely theoretical. According to the math of white holes, they can only theoretically exist as long as there isn't a single particle of matter within the event horizon of the white hole. Even if a single hydrogen atom drifted into the region, the entire thing would collapse. There are several theories about white holes. One is that a black hole singularity would compress down into the smallest region possibly possible, and then it would rebound as a white hole. But if you consider the large time dilation effect going on, this would take billions of years for even the low mass black holes to rebound as a white hole. Microscopic black holes formed right after the Big Bang might explode as white holes sometime right now. But if you remember Hawking radiation, the black holes would have already evaporated, especially the low mass ones, because smaller black holes evaporate faster than larger ones. Another theory is that white holes might be one possible explanation for the Big Bang, but as I mentioned, white holes are most likely just theoretical and don't exist, just another concept of our imagination. This might be the same case for Kugel blitzes and wormholes, for example. Comment down below whether you think white holes exist or not, and give your reasons. Make sure you subscribe for more content on astronomy and futurism. If you enjoyed this video, check out my most recent video or my playlist on black holes. Thank you so much for watching. Have a nice day.